Let's explore colors and styles. Colors in the cells can be used to help provide context into the information at a glance. If you just created a new view, you might not have any styles, and it might look something similar to this. Black text on blue, and when you select on operations, related operations show as black text on green. Let's say that we wanted to visually identify which steps were finished. Let's work through that example. So we navigate to view, we're going to edit our view, and we'll notice that in our case, our data source has no filter. So we're going to be looking at released steps as well as simulated orders. We're going to create a new style, and we're going to call this finished step. We need to make sure that our table matches the same data source table that we're using. We're going to want the text to be white. We're going to want to have the background color to be red. Now we're going to use the filter to make sure that this coloring only applies when the routing status is finished. If you forget to do the filter, it's going to apply this coloring to everything. So let's see that first. So we'll see here that it's applied that style to all of the cells. And we only want that cell to be applied to the routing status of finished. So we're going to head back to review, edit it. We're going to define that filter. Before you define the filter, make sure it's on the right table. We're going to choose where the routing status is finished. And now we'll see only the finished steps are colored as red. Now, since our data source is showing us both released and simulated orders or any other orders, let's color code the simulated orders as something different. So let's head into view. We're going to edit it. We're going to create another style. We're going to call this simulated orders. We're going to make sure it's on the right table. And when this occurs, we're going to want to choose the background color of, let's go for yellow with black text. We're going to set our filter. To simulated orders. We can now see at a glance the finished steps before from the red coloring and all the simulated orders. You'll notice that as you're selecting the cells, that will still apply. And that's how you change colors in the graphical scheduler.
Hey, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for more great content.